Hello, this is Alex, and welcome back to the Minecraft server. I'm gonna show you a few things I've done since last time. I showed a little of it last night when I did a live stream, but I don't know if, well, obviously all of you weren't there, but so I'm just gonna show some of you some of the stuff. I've been enchanting some more, gotten some more of these work picks here. And another efficiency 5 one. I really can't tell the difference between efficiency 4 and 5 on SMP. I got a lot of fortune ones and 2 silk touch, and yeah, I accidentally started using 2, I didn't notice, so I just put that back. I actually need some dirt, so let me grab some of that. Let's see, I have been building. Yeah, I just built a thing down here. We can go take a look. I just dug down this. It's going through. You can see all the caves that are absolutely everywhere. And I just started digging some 3x3 tunnels in each direction. And I think I might be. I don't know if I'm gonna branch mine down here or what. But I'm down at level 10. Just to see if I was getting more diamonds by doing it at level 10. When you hit lava, it's a lot slower because you can't just pour water on it or something. You actually have to go through it like I did here. There's lava behind these blocks somewhere. Yeah, there. Uh-oh. Okay, we used dirt there. Why is there darkness up there? Darkness is not allowed. Oh, stupid. I can't block stuck up there. There. And there's more darkness over here. Oh, I haven't even been here. This is weird. Well, it's hard to find little pockets like this. Okay, I don't see anything. Let's put it up there. Get some more lights. Going. Yeah, I just wanted to see if I would find any diamonds, and I haven't found a single one actually, which is a little bit weird. Oh, there's some iron here. I can bring that back. What else? I did a. Well, I think it's easier to just show you than tell you. So, let's get back up here to my house. Thingy. I don't know if I should call this my house or okay, and one dirt. Okay, back here I made a tree farm because I need different kinds of wood. Oh, sorry. No. Oh, stupid, these things are too good. For different projects, I'm gonna need different kinds of colored wood, and I actually don't have any jungle tree saplings, so I can't grow those in here. I don't think I have though. I'm not sure. Okay, 3 of them grew. Good. As long as I get enough back, I don't care about the rest of the saplings. Yeah, and I just did, this was a cave right here. I just dug out this room, and it looked a little bit bare with just these flat walls, so I dug like a row out here all the way around, put torches up, and it still didn't look, well, it looked a little bit flat, so I just added coal ore all the way along, all the way around. Not because I'm gonna mine it to get the coal, just for, you know, decoration. And yeah, it's nice, it's different, and I like that. And these doors just lead into the cave system about around here. So I made that. That's to the ravine. We've got the sand generator down there. Let's see what else. I built something else up here. I'm not gonna. There's no reason to carry this iron around. Okay. I built something else where I used actually my own tutorial over here. Push button to get free melons. And as you can see up there, melons. And I push this button and they all fall down. And I just put them in here. I'm not gonna eat them, but I'm gonna use them for potions, I think. Or as an emergency food source. And this is actually very simple. Oops, wrong tool. If you wanna build this, there is a tutorial on my channel. If you just search for tutorial, you should find it. I made it with Momo a while back. So what you do is you have this ring of dirt with a hole in the middle and then just a block with a piston above. And down here there's a redstone torch behind the block with the button on, that's on the other side there, that travels up, and then the redstone signal, stop that, just travels over there to this repeater, which then sends the signal into the block there, which then sends the signal over to the pistons. And the same deal over here. Let's see if we can see it. So the signal comes from the torch down there, through here into this block, and up to this block to power this piston, and the same on this side to that piston over there. And by using glowstone here, I can actually draw the redstone power through here. The glowstone doesn't cut the wire, and I can also continue the redstone up here and then up here to get all of these power. So it's very simple to build. It doesn't take up a lot of space. It's a 5x5, and then a little bit here on the back side. And I'm just gonna close this there and there. And I just did a little finessing in here so the room isn't all plain. Oh, no mod. Oh well. Okay, so at some point I'm gonna make a better entrance to this, but for now I just did this, and I removed them from down there. I only grow pumpkins down there. In here, I dug out this room to make it bigger. I wanted a higher ceiling in here instead of a low one like this, because this room is so large. I think it needed a higher ceiling just to get a better look, a better feel for the room. And I tried something, I don't know what to put on the walls in here. I tried this just to see what it looked like. I like it, but yeah, I don't know yet if I should do something else. I tried this one, but I think I'm gonna stack boxes, chests in here up, so I don't think that will work. But if it was just for a wall effect, I think that may be better. Maybe use a different kind of wood in there, I don't know. And I have these pillars here that's supposed to support the ceiling, and this is inside the mountain, so I wanted to make it look like I had to hold up the ceiling. So oops, I missed that. I want to have this pillar that go up here continue up and over and connect to this one. This is gonna continue up there, I think, and then have a cross beam at this level, I think, go across to here, and then just have exposed room in between here. But I don't know yet. I just started trying to dig out this area up here, and I'm going to see what it looks like, but I'm going to continue with that. Also, I'm gonna get rid of one of these stacks. Outside, you see when I raised the roof in here, I dug up, I actually hit the top of the mountain here. Oh, and I think it just started raining again. Yeah, it did. Okay. Yeah, and I got a hole in my roof now. See, it should be raining over here. Yeah. My roof is leaking. And I need some way to finish this. I think the room is gonna end at this point. Like, it should. I think it's gonna end at that pillar back there. But I don't know yet. If you guys have any suggestions for the walls, the ceiling, the floor, decoration in here, and so on and so forth, feel free to let me know. So this is up to... I had a little area here, a little cove underneath this. And this is now all gone because I dug it all out. I finished this thing. And... I think it looks better with the flat side walls. You can see... I continued the glass. I filled in all the gaps all the way up, so the side is completely flat. And I think it looks better. There's less detail to confuse the eye, although there's still a lot of detail inside because of all the glass blocks everywhere. But I like it a lot, and I'm very happy that you've given me such positive feedback on this. I think still I want to try putting glass all the way around these, just to see what it looks like. I haven't gotten any feedback on that, so I think I'm just going to try it. Someone wrote me and said I should make this area, instead of a 2 wide and 1 deep, I should make it 2 by 2 or something, so I could hit the guys both in front of and the back. And I know I could do that, but I'm not using this as an XP farm at all. And I don't care that I'm wasting a little bit of food by clicking too fast and all that. I just want to be able to get some gunpowder and some bones and arrows and so on. And some of the other guys have been coming over here. Because I think at the moment this is the most effective mob farm on the server. Just, you know, been standing here AFKing and... getting some stuff. Oh, yeah. So, and I've been getting a lot of. Oh, stupid! Stop that. I've been collecting a lot of records as well as AIM has. Let's get rid of this. I think I have some more records over here. Yeah. See, all the ones I had duplicates of, I brought to the end. And we got a record player down there I brought, just so we have something. Let's see, what else did I do? I don't actually think I did anything else. One of the black sheep from over here made its way all the way into this pen. And how it did it, I have no clue. That's an escapist sheep. Yeah, I don't know. But I'm just breeding these whenever I stop by. Here comes the scary part. Oh, help. At some point I should make some kind of system, I guess. Help, get me out. No. Hilfe. Ah. Oh. I know there's some setups where you can have like conveyor belts with carts for all the cows and so on, but I don't want to make it that effective, so to speak. I think I like these free roaming things, although it's hard to get working on SMP. But I think I like this better. Yeah. I've been putting up some more torches around here. Even though there's a lot, especially if you look at the map. And I've been caving a little bit more, just to get all the farms more effective. And let's see if it's been working. Hello, guys. Yeah, I really, this is always full now when I come in here. Oh, by the way, I talked to Momo today. And, oh, shoot, hello. How did you get out here? He's having a good time in China, and I showed him some of the stuff here. He can't really watch video YouTube videos over there, and he can't really play Minecraft. So poor guy, he's so far behind on watching all of the different videos on YouTube and playing the game. And I think he's looking very much forward to getting back home. Okay, I think I'm gonna work on this some more up here, and when I've got a little progress to show, I will come back and show you some of it. See if I can get this thing here to look somewhat decent. I don't know what I'm gonna do. We'll see. I'll be right back. I got a little more done here. I'm just taking down the scaffolding, so to speak, so we can see what it looks like. Need to pick up all of this. But it's very hard, this interior designing, decorating. I'm not very good at it. And this is a huge room, so I think it's hard to get it to look good. So I was thinking something like this. I like this trim of a cobblestone here and here, so I thought I would continue it up there and have that little, those little details, just to give it some character or something, I don't know. And then have the wood beams go atop like this. Of course, remove that that's back behind there, like I did over here. But then I don't know what to do about this wall. And how to finish this. I put in the pillars. I thought there would be in the way a lot, but it's actually not that bad. We can do this one, so let's see. Here, 5. So here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is the roof, and it needs to go up a few more. I forget how many. Let's just say 10. Oop. Oh, I didn't make it. Better eat something. Okay, so the pillars are also a way for me to get some light in here, because these rooms, large as this, can be hard to light up, I think. But yeah, I don't know. But I think it looks nice. I need to finish that thing I have over there, finish that here, and then do this all the way down. And then see what the room looks like. I could maybe make like storage up there as well, but I actually think I would prefer it more if you could, if you can see up to the high ceiling like this. I think it looks very nice. Yeah, I'm gonna continue. Okay, I just wanna give you a little update. I got some more progress here. I'm just gonna take down this scaffolding so we can get a better sense of what's what here. And this one we need to take down from this side. I put these ladders on some of the columns here, because I got tired of block stacking up and down all the time. Okay, so let's see what it actually looks like. I'm not done by a long shot, but I think I've done enough that I can get a good impression of what it's gonna look like. Yeah, I think it's okay. I don't know if I should change some of the blocks. Yeah, You guys let me think what you let me know what you think, okay? Because I'm really struggling here. I have no idea. This large room is hard to take on. I'm about, yeah, I'm actually exactly halfway done, because there's six sections, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the walls here, and I got half of them done, and it's taken me a long time. So this episode is gonna be a short one. Let's see. Panda just got home from somewhere, and apparently he just saw the video where Team Canada pranked Sisto on the Minecraft server. So I thought Itchy was, oh shoot, was heading over here. He wants to borrow the this thing here to get some gunpowder and such. Yeah. Okay. I want to see if I can actually get back in there. I made a beautiful shot earlier today. I don't know if I can reproduce it. Where is it? It's up there. I landed right next to my furnaces. Oh, well, this is new. I didn't have that then. Okay. So I'm gonna continue this, I think. And I hope to get some nice feedback from you on what I should do, how I should do. Also the floor here, I have no clue. Yeah. So thank you for watching. I hope you had fun, and I will see you next time. Bye.